Hi everyone, welcome to the three stages of tennis training. We're going to start with stage number three. Reason being is, most of you will never do stage one and two. And three is probably the most important one. The maintenance stage. This is the stage tennis players must go through when they're competing. It has to do with resistance, joint health, and keeping the integrity of your muscle strength. The goals in the third stage are not to overstrain, but to increase blood flow and to maintain strength. Here you'll see me using the rubber bands to add some resistance, and I'm working on my rotator cuff. I'm doing some side movements. In a little bit, you'll see me doing some movements up high. My goal here is to strengthen my shoulder. As tennis players, our shoulders get really beat up. Especially those of us that have a little bit of improper form. The muscles get overstrained. They get imbalanced. They get pulled. They get torn. And injuries are really, really detrimental to our progress. I'm going to use this long clip as an opportunity to talk about tennis cycle training. Some people call it periodization. Usually, the full cycle takes anywhere between 3 and 9 months. Let's take a 3-month cycle, for example. The first month should be concentrated on building muscle mass. You need muscle mass as a tennis player because your body will use it as fuel when it's going through these long, protracted 3-set or 5-set matches. When you do train for muscle during stage one, make sure that you're not training in such a way to build size. You do not want hypertrophy. You want to be explosive on the way up when you do your exercise, and you want to slow down on the way down. You want to train your muscles to be explosive. So even in stage one, you're not training like a regular bodybuilder. Tennis training is very different. Our goals are different. We need to build our bodies different. Stage two is plyo. During the second stage, you're basically working your cardio, your explosiveness, your endurance. It's very difficult to go through all these exercises. Stage two is probably the hardest one. It involves a lot of medicine ball work, sprinting, jumping. It's one of those workout till you puke. And stage three is this. Maintenance. During your third month, you should be competing already, and you want to do these exercises after matches, as warm-up, before and or after training. Personally, I like to do them before training and then do some stretches after training. This exercise is also part of the maintenance program. It has to do with balance. Once you get on, see if you can shift your weight around without falling off. The medicine ball will help you with some extra strain and will help you keep balance.
Go forward. Do the lean.
Oh yeah.
Some of these exercises may require a partner, but you could try to do them without tossing the ball. The effect is similar. Here, we run into an old timer at the gym.
Tennis pro, so I try to teach him some tennis techniques.
Up above his head.
Oh, above.
There you go. Oh, you see how that? Yeah. Did you see how that worked? Nice job, what's your name?
Casey.
Nice job, Casey.
Stretching is also part of the maintenance stage. This stretch here is the mother of all tennis stretches. Notice the position of the toes on both feet. You can push yourself around in the stretch to hit virtually every muscle used in tennis training or playing a match. Usually the hamstrings and calves get really sore, really tight for tennis players. Most of the cramps that I see happen in the calf. This stretch is really good if you can do it. Keep your back foot on the toes or on the ball of your foot if you can manage. And go as far forward along your leg as you can. I would hold that position for a little bit if you can stand it. Especially on the right leg or your dominant leg, it's extremely painful.
Do it.
You know this one hurts.
Well, that was the maintenance stage. Next, I'll be giving examples of the type of exercises a tennis player should be doing during stage one, muscle buildup. Some of my favorite things to do are full body exercises. This is one of them. The weight used should be somewhere between 55% to 70% of your maximum. You can probably do anywhere between 8 to 20, sometimes even 25 reps on each exercise, depending on your strength and your endurance. These are examples of some bench flies, some incline flies. This one's my favorite here. It really works out my lats, my back. In general, though, you want to be pretty symmetric with your workout. Don't overdo one specific muscle group. That's one of the reasons why I lean towards full body exercises. You can do a lot with single dumbbells. Here we're working out the serving arm. This one hits the tricep, but we're doing it a little bit differently. We're pronating, emulating a serve. The offhand is used to try to keep the elbow and arm position stable. We're trying to prevent that elbow from buckling. Same thing on the left arm, just to stay symmetric. Time for some forearm buildup with the bar.
Yeah, just like that. Try to go fast on the way up and then slowly on the way down.
This one here is a little bit tricky. You have to let the bar roll down your fingers. Make sure that you keep the thumb on the inside of the bar and use it to assist in curling the bar upwards. That way your thumb gets a workout too. To build up some of your bigger muscle groups, you're gonna need to do leg press. You can do it in squat format like this, or you can lay down on your back and push upwards, or you can do both. Isolating the hamstrings is a pretty good idea for tennis players. Some of us don't use them as much as we should, and so the machine provides us an avenue of balancing out the muscle groups.
Flex those muscles.
Again, even when you're using machines, make sure that you put the weight at something that you can handle. It does you no good to overstrain your muscles. As a tennis player, working out is cross-training. If you injure yourself cross-training, you're doing something wrong. Put the weight at 50% max, 60% max, sometimes even less, just to work on technique. For the machines, feel free to consult with the trainer to make sure that you're doing them properly. That's gonna do it for the muscle building section. Next up, stage 2. plyo. Go grab a medicine ball. Get into a lunge position. Start doing forehands and backhands. This one is probably one of the hardest ones to execute properly. The lunge position is important. Make sure that your knees over the arch of your foot or over a little bit in front of the heel. You can see Casey stepping out here, but you can also pivot in the same spot where your left foot is. You can pivot on the inside of your toes for a cleaner open stance turn. But this is probably one of my favorites. Here, I'm showing how to do the next exercise. From a split step, you want to do a drop step, run back, catch the ball, run forward, pass it back on, split step, drop step, run, catch, pass it back forward. Yep, that was hard. Next one is really good. It imitates tennis footwork. Make sure that you do open stance retrieval. You can see the left leg on the left side, right leg on the right side. On the short ones, you can step in with the opposite leg, imitating stepping in on a short ball. This workout is also really exhausting. We can round out stage 2 plyo workout with some abs. This one is probably one of my favorite ab machines here, but there's a ton of stuff you can do with medicine balls, with yoga positions. Feel free to work out your abs in any manner that you like. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed the video and the examples of the 3 stages of tennis training. That about ties up all the loose ends. I'm going to leave you with some on-court exercises you can do anywhere. Prove me wrong, I hit a threefold. No demons, they hold me down. Time to fly, they can't slow me down. Believe, call me out, slow me down, I won't fall out. I stand tall, I face off, I crawl out till I ball out. Believe. Just believe. Haters gonna hate, but for me I can't relate. Just believe. Money on my mind, when you leave it all behind. Just believe. Haters gonna hate, but for me I can't relate. Just believe.